Are you in the market for a small SUV? Do you like luxury? And do you love letters and numbers? Well, we've got the perfect vehicle for you because this is the 2020 Mercedes-Benz GLB-250. And we're gonna take a look and see if it's worth your time and money. Mercedes would love for you to consider this a baby G-Class, but come on, no. What you should consider, though, is the fact that this looks a lot like the rest of the crossover SUV lineup. And that's a good thing, because Mercedes crossover design for the last few years has been getting better than ever. Well, the opposite might be said for their sedan and coupe and convertible market. So their crossovers are looking strong, and this just looks like a scaled-down version of the GLS and the GLE and the GLC and a slightly bigger version of the GLA. And that's good. Engine! That is an engine. That's a 2-liter turbocharged 4-cylinder, and it makes 221 horsepower and a rather impressive 258 pound-feet of torque, and it is available low and throughout the rev range. Now, if that's not enough for you, though, get ready, because AMG is coming out with the GLB-35, which will have a similar engine, but it makes 302 horsepower. And then if you really need more than that, there's a GLB-45 coming, and estimates are high 300 to low 400 for the horsepower range on that one. So despite the boxy proportions on the outside, this doesn't weigh as much as you think it might. It's just under 4,000 pounds, which these days is good, and that helps ease the burden of the motor under the hood. I already told you about the horsepower and torque, and that torque is available from as low as 1800 RPM, and that helps this feel sprightly. It can get out of its own way. I read, per Mercedes' own numbers, 0 to 60 is 6.9 seconds, which is not quick these days, but is not gonna get you killed merging onto the highway either. Now, continuing on the notion that Mercedes would like you to think of this as a baby G-Class, which I already said is laughable, the display here does remind me of the G-Class, because it is the same style long screen. 10.25-inch touchscreen on one side, digital cluster on the other side. It does look good. It does remind me of the G-Class, though it is not as nicely integrated, which you would expect for a more affordable vehicle. Let's see if we can beat this other Mercedes off the line. We can. See? Not bad. And this is just the front-wheel drive model, which is good because you save $2,000 off the purchase price. There is optional 4MATIC all-wheel drive, though. When you do get the all-wheel drive version, the standard torque split is 80-20. That's 80 front, 20 rear. You can pop it into sport mode, and now you've got 70-30 split. There's an off-road mode as well, which divvies it up 50-50. The 8-speed dual clutch is responsive enough if you put it in sport mode. In comfort, though, it is a bit on the sluggish side, but you can always grab a paddle and force it into a gear that you'd prefer. But just put this in sport and you should be good. I have it set to individual right now. I have the drive, which is basically the throttle response, and the transmission set to sport. I have the suspension set to comfort, and then steering and the electronic stability program are put into sport. And I don't know why I put ESP in sport, because it is not like I'm drifting this thing. Mercedes fits all GLB class vehicles with its AI system, because it's the future. It's an extension of their MB user experience system. And to operate it, it's as simple as saying, "Hey, Mercedes.
How may I help you?
Tell me a joke." Takes a while.
Sorry, I'm busy looking at the road.
Oh. Slam. Earlier it said, "I can't do that because I was designed by German engineers," which is a joke and is in fact funny. The system, though, is stuff that you can handle with some presses of buttons or the touchscreen or the trackpad down here. In certain instances, it'll be helpful to keep your eyes on the road to use it, but I mean, don't use it for things like turning the radio up and stuff like that. So the big sticking point with the GLB is going to be the price. These things start around $37,000, which is pretty good, because this does feel like a Mercedes inside. You can see that the dash is, it's soft on top, but it looks a little cheaper. And then there are some elements that look nice, but are like pretend versions of the nicer things. But that's how a car like this should be. The problem is, when you start to option these up, it is possible to spend well into the $50,000 range. I actually priced one out online the other day, and I spent $62,000. I did that on purpose to see how much I could spend. And that wasn't with every option, but it was with most of them. And that is crazy. If you bought a GLB 250 for $62,000, bravo to Mercedes. This one, as equipped, though, because this is a front-wheel drive model and has some good packages, it does have some nice options on it, like the AMG line exterior look with those fancy black wheels. This one is $49,000. If you keep a GLB under $50,000, now we're talking, that's a good place to be. Otherwise, just jump up and get the GLC if you really want something like that. But just in terms of overall driving dynamics, this thing drives well, you know, for a front-wheel drive crossover. There's nothing to get excited about, but it's not bad either. I like the chunky, thick rim steering wheel in my hands. The seats are comfortable enough. I would never get white seats though in a car, especially because I have a 5-year-old. There is also, oddly enough, a 3-row version of this. There is no 3-row version of the GLA because how? And there is no 3-row version of the GLC. There is an optional 3-row version of this, and Mercedes, by their own admittance, says, use it if you really need to, or if you have very short people that you want to put in the back. It's mostly just kind of an optional, like, okay, I guess we got to throw somebody back there. You do not need the 3-row version of this. If you need a 3-row crossover, spend your money in a different place. If you need a small 2-row, 5-passenger crossover, though, and you want to have a fancy pointed star on the front, it's not a bad option. If you want the $2,250 driver assistance package, you can't get it with the glowing star, but that's probably for the better because this is what it includes. Active cruise control, active steering assist, evasive steer assist, lane keep, speed limit assist, pre-safe plus, route-based speed adaption, and then something called pre-safe sound, which emits a noise to protect the driver's hearing in the event of a big bang during an impact. I do recommend the $2,240 for the AMG line because you get AMG body styling, perforated front discs, and AMG diamond block grille in the nose. But you do have to spend an extra $1,050 for the cool black wheels. And that steering wheel I mentioned, it's another $360. So the 2020 GLB from Mercedes is a smart choice if you want a luxurious crossover and you keep the price at $50,000 or less. Once you go over that, it starts to get a little bit ridiculous. Spend your money wisely, and if you want one of these, you've got a handsome machine in a small package.